Okay, before we get actually into the course itself, I want to make sure you understand what we're going to be covering today and the course outline. For those of you at home, it's there on the screen. For those of you here in the class, it's on the monitors in your outline. So we're going to talk about literally what is a contingency. We're going to talk about what a contingency is specifically, and then we're going to talk about contingency clauses in real estate as well. We're going to talk about what is a contingency and what does it actually mean. We're going to talk about some of the ways that you can write a great contingency for your clause or your client. We're going to cover how to clear a contingency. And for those of you at home, I'm using the finger quotes. It's called clearing a contingency. Hence the word, when you guys get the title company that says we're clear to close, there are contingencies that are inherent in our purchase agreement, and we've cleared all of those. Now, when we add new contingencies, we have to clear them as well. We're going to talk about two specific documents, the purchase agreement and the inspection response, and how we can write contingencies in both the purchase agreement and your inspection to protect your client. Now, you can put contingencies in just about every clause, I would imagine. I've not gone through every form the IAR has, but I'm sure that you can write a contingency, all right? Then we'll sum this up and finish the course, all right? Any questions? So that's what we're covering, and before we get into that, do we have anything else? No? If you've got questions at home, remember you can email me any of your questions at raymond@realuniversity.com. All right? So let's get started with the course.